The 8 Mississippi. 89 Mississippi, and we're almost there. 90 Mississippi. I don't really get them for a second. Welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. Always got a shout out door behind you. Coming up on the show today, as if star Emily Curry's here, going to be talking conspiracy theories with me about what's going on in the house. Also, if you need tips on how to survive in confined spaces, Adrian, Anne and the dog Jasmine are here with their amazing caravan to reveal all. Plus, the super fans have landed. Today is the first ever Superfan Sunday. Yay! And here they are, and they are in good spirits. We're kicking off with them in mind. We're kicking off, as we always do, with Little Brother's Big News. The Bedsit takes its first victory over the housemates when the milkman discovered his cold water treatment extended to the bath. Take a look at this.
Look at this! He's wearing the chokers! You wear the chokers, man! I'm having a bath! And these guys are maniacs, I'm telling you, man.
And Whitney's super fan, who is in fact Victor's fiance, even though he doesn't know it yet, is over there, and she is not happy about that already. Oh dear, she wants to kick off. At 12:10 today, Emma and Michelle quite literally turned on the waterworks and stopped the housemates sunbathing.
It'd be great just to get like a 2-week run of this weather, wouldn't it?
You just stopped laughing, Vic.
Yeah, you were all laughing at me, innit? It was funny it was me,
innit? And finally, this afternoon, there was another argument when, surprise, surprise, Marco asked Ahmed why he doesn't like him.
Ahmed, why do you dislike him so much?
You started the game. You have been manipulative with me from day two or day three. And that all started. But then, the thing of last night, I'm still honest. I can't be false, you know?
Well, don't be then.
But then, I can't comfort, don't expect
fine,
from
that's
me.
Cool. Don't
okay,
be there.
I just walk away. We got enough friends here. Don't need me.
And that was Little Brother's Big News. On Friday night, Michelle and Emma were evicted not from the house into the Big Brother bedsit. They're having fun and shenanigans already, but it naturally leads us to today's cool BBLB, which is, out of all of the housemates, who would you least like to be stuck in a bedsit with and why? Here's how to get in touch. You can call BBLB on 09011 225 2252. That's 09011 225 2252. Or you can text us your comments. Just put studio, then a space, then your message, and then send it to 83188. Or you can email us at bblb@channel4.com. Who would I hate to be locked up with? Oh, let me have a think. No, I can't think of anyone, but enough of all that. It's superfluous because it's Sunday, and that means the super fans are here, and that can only mean one thing. It's Superfan Sunday. You've got your arm up in the air. Thank you, Claire. Trouble already. Interesting. Get rid of her. Okay, 2 weeks ago, we asked you to get in touch. If you were not that much, but buku of a fan of one of this year's housemates. We were looking for one ultimate fan for each of our housemates, the super fan who would come here every single week and fight tooth and nail for their cause. Angry people. People that got problems. People with a purpose. People that have no social life. They are here. Thousands of you applied. Actually, 750 of you applied. We invited you to a shortlist of 33 to an audition. 11 were the chosen ones. Here's how that choice was made.
A Of the thousands that applied to represent their favourite housemate, Little Brother producers whittled it right down to 33 people, three for each remaining housemate, and they were chosen to take part in the Superfan auditions. The first stage consisted of each person having 30 seconds to persuade the bosses on why they have the divine right of representing their favourite housemate throughout the series.
I want to be a super fan because I feel that Big Brother is quite a large part of my life.
I will devote my entire summer to being Jason's super fan.
I should be Stuart Wilson's super fan because I know what it's like to be an intelligent person surrounded by idiots.
Yeah, I'm probably the male equivalent of Emma.
I love a good romance, and the Michelle and Stuart thing's got everyone talking.
Marco's fantastic, so camp and so gay.
And then I arrived to split the groups into three tables, each with one fan for each housemate. Each group was given possible scenarios to discuss.
Stuart didn't have much of a choice in kissing her. She kind of bounced on her a little bit. So I don't think there's going to be any major politics. It's not really anyone's business. It doesn't really matter.
Emma puts herself into a position where she knows herself too well.
From that, our best 11 were chosen. And all that was left was for the winners to comfort the losers and then prepare for their new double lives as superfans.
And here they are, the final mob. And I've written a little song for them, which we've been rehearsing, and it goes something like this. There is power in a superfan.
Hey!
I think that deserves a round of applause for the superfan. Oh, right, we're going to do this like Hill Street Blues. I'm going to start with a roll call. You're going to say here, and then I'm going to ask you a question, all right? Yeah. So the fantastic discerning public at home can get to know you all. Everyone happy with that?
Yes.
Excellent stuff. Glenn.
Here.
Brilliant. The big question is, does Stu really fancy Michelle? You're Stuart's superfan.
I am indeed, Dermot. I think he does to a degree. I think it's such an interesting environment in there. Everything's heightened, so I think, yes, he does, but maybe not as much as he would in the real world.
Do you think she's slightly more warm for his form than the other way around?
Oh, yes. Do you see that? Him lying in bed like that, looking like a rabbit in the headlights.
Well, next up is Dave.
That's me.
Shell's super fan. That's is she right. Really nice as she makes out?
She's even nicer than she makes out.
Even nicer?
Even nicer than she makes
Why?
Out.
Why? What is it about her, you love?
Oh, apart from
the tutu and the leg warmers.
That's the, that's all of
them. Okay, good. We've got Claire, Michelle's super fan.
Yeah.
Now then. Is she a little bit jealous at the moment with what's going on?
Well, she's a little bit insecure anyway, and yeah, I think she's finding Shell's antics a little bit annoying.
All right, no need to look at him like that. He's not Shell.
Oh, he's representing Shell. It's bad enough.
Okay, cool. Now, I have to point out, you two are in a bedsit at the moment, obviously, because Emma and Michelle are in a bedsit. So if you are ever naughty, then I can quite easily just pull back these neck curtains.
We haven't been yours naughty yet.
You haven't been naughty yet, that's true. So
behave ourselves.
Okay, who we got next? We've got Louise, Marco's superfan. That wasn't a big hand.
Hey!
That's more like it. And Wayne Nadia's super fan.
Hey!
I'll ask you two together. I mean, they're part of the Marcos Harim, the lip gloss gang. They've got two of their big allies, their big friends, are in exile over there in the bedsit, as you can see. Played very brilliantly by these two. How will they cope?
Nadia will cope very well, I think. She's a strong personality. She doesn't offend anyone at all, really. And at the end of the day, Dermot, there's more to Nadia than lip gloss.
Yes, indeed. And how? And how about Marco? How's he going to cope?
I think Marco's been really open and honest with everyone in the house, and I think that's quite a strong attribute, and it is very much appreciated in there. I think his personality shines. It's more shinier than any lip gloss on the earth.
Big fan. OK, next we've got Tony.
Yep.
Excellent. That's Emma's super fan. You're obviously in the bed sit there. What is it about this girl? She's infectious, isn't she?
She's great. She's lively. She's endearing. They all love her. She's in for a good time. She's got no hidden agendas. You see is what you get.
She does walk in people when they're on the toilet.
She's just a little bit forgetful, that's all.
Amazingly forgetful.
Amazingly.
She's dyslexic as well. She can't read the signs.
I mean, if you read the signs, if you've seen her reading the signs...
Dyslexia has nothing to do with whether someone's in the toilet.
Well, no,
sure.
But they've got this thing, please knock. So obviously, she's walking up there not acknowledging that
she's
that's
sexy,
there.
She can read.
I mean, you know, to defend her, she had that huge argument with Victor. So why go through that? Why be shouted at and then within 10 minutes walking on Vanessa? She's just very forgetful, and then when a girl's got to go, Dermot, a girl's got to go.
Okay, next up, Whitney, Victor's super fan.
Hi there.
How do you think it's going to